Discovering Kazakhstan is Jonathan Newell's unbiased view on culture and the mode of life of Kazakh people, on amazing landscapes and architectural masterpieces all over Kazakhstan.
We've arrived for the second day of celebrations of the 550th anniversary of the Kazakh Khanate here in the center of Astana. Well, today it's all about the enjoyment of the people, and you can see that they've set out this square very beautifully with all kinds of decorations that signify the past of Kazakhstan. There's some yurts here, etc. So that's what we're going to do today. We're going to have a look at how people are celebrating this very, very important anniversary for Kazakhstan. Yurt here, which represents a company in Almaty that it specializes in the restoration of very old weapons of the old Kazakh era, and it's a fascinating place. They've got all sorts of interesting things here, and I want to start with this. It might not look like a weapon, but this was actually the drums that the batirs of ancient times used to play in order to gather together the troops and to build up their spirit ready for the war. And so this is how they would gather everybody together like that. It's made of the hide of a bull, and this beautiful, beautiful way that it's been carved down here. This represents the face of a snow leopard. And a snow leopard is a very symbolic part of Kazakhstan in terms of its history and also about its culture. So this is the snow leopard drum that the batirs would use. But there's much more than that that's here. If I show you around this yurt, there's all sorts of different things here, like this armor. There are a few musical instruments here. And this, if we look at that absolutely beautiful helmet that's on top of this chest. But look at this chest, and look at all of these inlays here. All carved bone. There are different metals here, different kinds of wood that have been used in the creation of this chest. You can see here various different books as well. These ones are in the English language. And there's some fantastic pictures of all the different weapons and all the armor that have been restored by this company. They do a wonderful job. They do it mainly for museums, so the museums have authentic weapons that have been restored to their original glory, like this leather shield here. You can see that it's made of leather, but it's very, very hard like that. This grand armor from the Turkic era, very, very scary. Look at this face on the helmet. Very, very heavy armor, but very beautifully produced. You can see here the flexibility that's within that, so that when these were used on somebody's shin like that, they could move their legs and it would still be flexible. Similarly, there are these other large pieces here. This straps around the leg, in fact, and this is the kneecap. So this would be the upper leg part of the armor, and again there's the flexibility in that to be able to move the leg but still offer the essential protection that they needed in these very vicious wars that went on at that time, when the Kazakhs unfortunately had to fight off the Dzungar invaders from Western China. All sorts of different things here, the kind of weapons that they would use to disable horses or to trap people so they couldn't move. And then this kind of club weapon that is very reminiscent of an acorn. The choice of venue for this event is inspired, because we're in the Kazakh Yeli Square here, and it's surrounded by these modern buildings, incredible buildings, the very latest in architecture. And of course, all around us there's these yurts, and these represent the old culture of Kazakhstan and the connection between the two, which is what this festival of the 550th anniversary of the Kazakh Khanate is all about. It's about the past and it's about the future, and all of that idea is embodied this one place here with the square. Just look at some of these buildings, they're amazing.
From in amongst the throng of yurts on the city square, the magnificent marble Kazakh Yeli monument soars over 90 meters into the sky, symbolizing the collective optimism of the country in taking it from its past into a future of continued independence. an independence that has been fought for throughout the centuries and reflected in more traditional art forms.
This beautiful little art exhibition is being held in a yurt, and it's the perfect setting for such a place. You can see the light from the shanirak, natural light shining down on this centerpiece of the exhibition. There's no other lighting in here, it's just all naturally lit, and it's a very nice setting indeed. Well, the centerpiece is the 18th century minstrel Suyumbay, who lived at the time of the Batiyas. And in fact, the whole theme of this exhibition is about the Khans, about the 18th century, and of course the period before that. You know, even the music is very thematic, and you very much get an atmosphere of this place. So behind me you can see various different pieces of art. You can see how bright and bold these pictures are, and this is actually very typical of the kind of art that's produced in Kazakhstan by young artists that show this kind of period. Very, very optimistic, very bright colours, very clear and striking physical features on these people that are in here. And you can see on the next painting here that this shows a very pastoral scene with these batiyas and, of course, the very regal-looking man, the Khan, in the centre. So it's a very romanticised image of that time. But as I say, it's very typical of the young artists of Kazakhstan and the kind of things that they produce.
Very few of the pictures featured in this exhibition are by established artists, with most of them having been produced by students and teachers of the Art Academy in the city of Almaty.
These celebrations, of course, are not just about Astana. It's a national event, and there are celebrations taking place all over the country, in different cities, in different counties, everywhere. Well, also within the capital, around this square, there are these yurt, and they're all over the place, and all of them are from different regions of Kazakhstan. So this one's from the Atarao region. Over there, we've been to the Almaty region. All the different regions of Kazakhstan are all represented here in this square with their yurts and their own specialities of their own part of the history, their own part of what they did since the Kazakh khanate 550 years ago. And I think all these yurts look beautiful, don't they, when they're all spread out like that in a line. I think they look fantastic. Because of the conferences, the various different exhibitions and things that are going on during this period at the moment in Astana, there are a lot of foreigners here at the moment. And you know, thinking about it, I think that these foreigners will have quite a big surprise at seeing the various different events and the different exhibits that are here. Because, you know, Kazakhstan is a very deep place. It has a very rich cultural tapestry to it, and I have to admit, even after having more than 10 years of association with the country, it still amazes me in many ways, because you know, the cultural diversity and the depth of the culture here is so great that you just peel layers and layers of it away and you find more hidden depths to it. It's a fascinating place, it really is. And I think and I hope that the various foreigners who are here at the moment will be experiencing that and will see that to a great extent, even just here on this square with all of these exhibits around, which shows that richness of diversity. One of the things that Kazakhstan is famous for today is all the different nationalities that live here together. Well, that's something that's not new. And if we go back to the time of the Kazakh Khanate, that's what it was like at the time. There were various different tribes, different clans that lived throughout the territory of the country. And that's reflected in a lot of the styles. And you can see it in the styles of the art and of the furniture. And indeed, you can see it in the styles of the yurt. And if you look behind me here, you can see some of those regional variances in the style of the way that the yurt has been built. You can see the one that looks like a marquee there. It has a kind of a very pointed roof. And the more traditional yurts that most people kind of associate with Kazakhstan, which are the dome-shaped ones that have the shanirak, which is the kind of symbol of infinity that's on the roof of them. That's the one that's become the mainstay of the yurt architecture of Kazakhstan. So why is the anniversary of the Kazakh khanate such an important event for Kazakhstan? Well, the establishment of the khanate 550 years ago is actually what established Kazakhstan as an independent nation. Well, for a long time in Kazakhstan's history, it lost that independence, of course, but it was regained again in recent history. That's where the country is now, and that's what's going to take it into its future. This is why the concept of the khanate is so important for Kazakhstan today and also Kazakhstan in the future.
Choosing which yurts to visit was like a mystery tour, with the doors to each one opening onto different scenes depicting different aspects of Kazakh culture, including art, artifacts, home styles, and of course the traditional meals laid out on the central table of the yurt, the dastarkhan.
Like any country in the world, the cuisine in Kazakhstan has changed over the centuries, but in fact, local cuisine hasn't changed so much. The basics that were always there are still there now. So the cuisine consists of quite a lot of meat and milk products and various things that you can get from the land that are based on wheat, primarily like bread, etc. But what we can see here is the dastarkhan, and this is the basic table that's within the yurt, and it's got the kind of spread on here that you can see these days, and you would also have seen 100 years ago, 200 years ago, or even at the time of the Khans. Mainly, it's about meat. So they had to use the various products that were available to them at that time, and that included a lot of products from animals, of course, milk, and the various wheat products. There's cheese. This is kurt, very hard, very salty cheese, delicious stuff. Different types of milk products from the camel and horse milk. And then, of course, the meat products, the various different sliced meats, the sausages that they make, and the lamb, which has been roasted and sectioned up here as part of the dastarkhan. The second day of the 550th anniversary of the Kazakh khanate has almost come to an end. But that's not the end of the celebrations. They're continuing on around Kazakhstan, and we're going to be following them around the country. And also, there's another day left here in Astana, which we'll be coming back to again tomorrow. So I hope you'll join me for that and for other episodes in discovering Kazakhstan to discover this wonderful country with me in the future. Goodbye.